Hey folks, welcome to BZBTV. My name's Chris, and today we're going to be going over BZBGEAR's three most popular PTZ live streaming cameras. This is a part one of two series. Part two will cover a little more of the other equipment, including switchers and whatnot. But for now, we're going to go over our cameras and some of the requirements in order to choose the proper equipment, as well as understand what's involved in the setup. So there are lots of great live streaming systems. However, it can be very confusing when it comes to selecting the proper equipment and understanding again how much time is involved to set up all the cameras, to set up joystick controllers, whatnot. The less equipment you have, the easier it is. But I always recommend that you're gonna wanna basically set aside all this equipment, start setting it up at least 2 weeks prior to doing your live stream. There is a lot involved, so make sure you got your tech hat on and you're ready to go. So let's go ahead and take a look at our three cameras that we're gonna be showing off today. One of them is our BG4K ND 12X, which actually you're watching right now in this recording. As you can tell, the colors are very natural. Everything looks realistic, it's sharp, image quality is excellent. So besides that, we'll show off the other two at the end of this episode. We're gonna toggle between all three cameras. We have two other 1080p's. Okay, so BZBGEAR cameras are always happy to rise to the occasion. So let's check them out. There we go. So as you can see here, we have three different essential form factors. We have our BG-VPTZ 10HSU3. This is a 10x optical zoom camera with 1080p output. We also have our BG-UPTZ 12x HSU. This is an amazing camera coming in black, white, and silver. And then we have the BG-4K NDI camera. This is our 12X version. We also have a 20X version coming out very shortly here. So what's cool about all three of these cameras is the fact that they supply an array of connections, meaning our VPTZ will give you a USB 3.0, an SDI, an HDMI, and a LAN port. So all four of these outputs can be utilized for streaming. Of course, if you're using SDI and HDMI, you will need a capture device of some sort or a mixer in order to convert that into a usable USB signal for live streaming software programs. If you wanted to use the LAN port for direct streaming, if you have just one camera, you could do that. Or if you wanted to set up what's called RTSP, Real Streaming Protocol, you could actually utilize that as well. Our BG-UPTZ over here, as you can see, it's got our USB 3.0, it's got HDMI, it's got SDI, and the LAN port. But the LAN port is an NDI HX LAN port, same as our 4K version here. It's gonna give you the ability to stream over the local area network. We'll go over that in a little while. Again, our BG-4K ND camera here has all the same connections except the SDI. So this does not have SDI. In order to get 4K through SDI cabling, you would need a 12G SDI output, which is pretty clunky still, so it makes the camera quite a bit bigger. However, in the near future, pay attention, and we do have a cool version coming out. So what is notably different on these cameras, besides the fact that the 4K doesn't have the SDI, but it has the USB 3.0 and the HDMI, is different lenses. These cameras all have different lenses. They have what's called web GUIs or web interfaces via a web browser. So essentially you need to network these cameras in order to access that, to do a bunch of different changes on video settings. We have adjusted our cameras for this particular shot. It was relatively simple. We didn't get real detailed into it. We just did it basically to the point where an average customer would adjust it. The white balance, for instance, a little bit of saturation. So as you can see, again, with the 4K camera, great image, looks awesome. Again, if I could move around, I had more space, I'd love to show you the zoom on it because it's really great in the autofocus as well. Now note, we do sell an array of other cameras. We have specialty cameras such as used for hobbyists, where it's called a pack shot. So you can get up and close to, say, jewelry. We have auto tracking cameras. We have box cameras. So, and of course, web cameras. So make sure to check out BZBGEAR.com if you're interested in some of our other models or styles of cameras. Before I go any further, I'd like to just let our folks know we are a one-stop shop manufacturer. So what that means is if you wanna purchase a camera from us, you can. If you wanna purchase a video switcher that we make, then you can. Same thing, joystick controllers, video converters, even HDMI extenders, SDI splitters. We basically carry virtually everything you need in order to do a full system setup. The only thing we don't carry is the audio mixer, but we'd be happy to point you the right direction on that. We can definitely give you a good hint on what's gonna work best for your equipment, basically since it's ours. We always recommend purchasing off one manufacturer when possible. The reason being is if you were to go purchase a camera from another company and a joystick controller from a different company, and maybe even a video switcher, you have three companies to deal with now, which means when you call for tech support on the camera, sure, they'll help you out, they'll give you great support, I'm sure. You'll get up and running, but then when you need the joystick controller to connect to the camera, if they can't get it to work in a few seconds, or if they even attempt, they're probably gonna say, sorry, you're gonna need to call that other company that manufactures that joystick controller. And then that company is gonna say, well, which camera do you have? Well, that's not our camera. So it can create some headaches and some frustrations for customers. That's why we decided to make sure we created all the equipment required in order to get you up and going, keeping the setup simple. That way you don't have a bunch of frustrations. And of course, our tech support department can help you. We have knowledge-based sections. We also have tons of video resources, just like this one here, to help those who like to follow along, hit pause, hit play. You can look at the rest of our videos. We got a ton of them. We just wanna make sure that our customers are happy with our purchases and that we're able to help them throughout the whole setup process. It's always beneficial to you and to our tech support team. It just makes things simple overall. Let's check out the VPTZ here, offered in 20X and 30X options, comes in silver. Again, USB 3.0, HDMI, SDI, a LAN port for direct live streaming or RTSP feed. This camera is amazing for educational facilities, houses of worship, live streaming, but we definitely find that our schools, universities that we've installed these in are very happy with them. They mount on the ceiling simple. You can do a USB 3.0 over an active USB cable because again, USB cables have a limitation of 15 foot, so you gotta make sure you get an active one. Or you can even do RTSP streaming from it, which we know one of the universities is currently doing. It's affordable, it's compact, and it's just overall easy to use. Next, we have our BG-UPTZ ND 12X. We carry this model in NDI version, which is what you're seeing now, but we also carry it in a non-NDI version. If you do not require NDI capabilities for streaming purposes, you can save a few bucks and go with the non-NDI version. But I typically recommend NDI. It's really nice to have, especially kind of completes all those connections, you know, with HDMI, SDI, USB 3.0, now you got NDI. So depending on the situation, whether your location changes or the environment changes, you have that flexibility to make those adaptations. Next, we got our BG 4K ND. Again, this comes in 12X. It's gonna be in 20X very shortly here. We're excited about that. It's amazing looking. No SDI, as I mentioned, but you do have the HDMI and you can do that via capture device. We also sell HDMI extenders here at BZBGEAR. Again, like I said, we supply all the equipment you could possibly need for your setup. This one, you're gonna do USB 3.0 or HDMI. You can do the LAN port if you like for NDI technology. We're gonna go over that connection in a minute to give you some more information on it. All of these cameras support all the control protocols you need. So what I mean by that for people who are not quite understanding that terminology is that joystick controllers need a special protocol. The protocol basically tells, sends commands back and forth so they can communicate. There's what's called serial connections, and then there's what's called IP control. So IP control is the preferred method. That means you connect your camera to the local area network switch, you connect your controller to the network switch, you network both devices so in the same neighborhood, and essentially you can control the camera without any other cabling required. And that uses, again, IPVISCA and ONVIF are the common protocols for that technology. If you prefer to do hardwired cabling, you can do RS-232, which is very common, up to about 50 feet. But we usually recommend going with RS-422 or RS-485. That uses bare wires like Cat5, Cat6. You strip the little ends back, you plug it in, typically two wires, and you can daisy chain. And it has much longer distance limitations versus RS-232. But if you can network it, again, it just saves time. It creates less headaches for actually having a daisy chain and run cabling and wiring, of course, depending on your establishment or your environment. So as I mentioned, we're gonna go over some of the connections. I'd like to give you a better idea and understanding of what these connections are and how you can utilize them. So let's start with the basic one, HDMI. As we know, high definition, multimedia interface, used on multiple devices, TVs especially, DVD players, cable boxes. It has a distance limitation of about 50 feet, unless you use a special active cable, which can get pretty expensive. So I usually do not recommend using HDMI unless it's for like a 4K application where the SDI is only like 3G. Which is only gonna pass 1080p. Then what you're gonna wanna do is get an HDMI extenders, so you can extend that HDMI signal if it's beyond 50 feet over a Cat 6 or a Cat 5 cable. That's gonna give you that signal back to the actual production station, such as this, if I had a mixer and switcher. That's the best route to go with HDMI. You can loop it out to a local monitor as well if you wanted to show what the camera was actually recording. Other than that, I would recommend SDI. SDI is the professional broadcaster's choice, meaning you can run this cable up to 328 feet. Professional broadcasters like it because it's durable, it's flexible, meaning that you can actually custom make your cable lengths on site. So if you need a 20 footer, you pull out 20 feet of cable, pop on two BNC connectors, you're good to go. If you need a 300 footer, because it'll go up to 330 feet, you can do that as well. Cable's inexpensive. It's basically RG6 coaxial cable, 75 ohm. We actually custom make these for our customers' convenience. So again, if you need SDI cabling, you say, hey, Chris, I don't know what exactly I need here. I don't know what connectors, and I sure don't make connectors. Just let our salespeople know like what size length you need. Tend to overestimate, because it's better to overestimate than underestimate, as most of you know. You don't want to get in that predicament where it's just a little too short. Next, USB 3.0. USB 3.0 limitations, as I mentioned, 15 feet. You can use a USB active cable, but again, limitations of that are typically about 66 feet. And after that, things can get a little strange. So we recommend USB 3.0 for shorter distances, essentially, and we do sell those as well. So if you only have a 25-foot run, just let us know, and we'd be happy to include one of those in with your system package. So lastly, NDI, as you heard me kind of throw that out there a few times. Some of you folks are familiar with it and some are not. NDI, essentially, is a streaming platform that was developed by a company called NewTek. And what it does is it's taking the video and audio and control signals out of the camera, and you're sending it over a Cat 5, Cat 6 cable into your network switch, and somewhere else at your control center, you can have the ability with your computer to actually run software programs such as vMix, which, by the way, we also bundle in for our customers' convenience. We do sell vMix if you need it. Other programs as well. There's free OBS studios. But these software programs will allow you to capture that NDI signal that's coming over the local network within the menu, and they will allow you to basically enter it into the streaming software, and you can have multiple cameras. And you can do your digital switching within the software program. Some folks like to get their hands on a hardware switch. They like to press 1, 2, 3, 4, and it's just more of a personal preference. And some people like to basically use live streaming software. They don't want to mess with any hardware devices. Again, that's up to you. But NDI has made leaps and bounds in making sure that the bandwidth compression is within tolerance, to help keep your network from bogging down or latency issues. But we do recommend, if you have more than one NDI camera, you're gonna wanna set up what's called VLANs. And this takes a professional network guy who's been in the field, he understands what VLANs are. It's just a better way to go. And what that does is it isolates your production equipment or your broadcasting equipment away from all the other devices. Say for instance, you have four NDI cameras going on, you got a joystick controller going on, you got all this information being transmitted, and suddenly you have, say for a house of worship, you have a service and you have 20 members come in and they all start using their phones and downloading videos, the kids are going crazy. Well, that's gonna create a lot of fogging and issues and interruptions in your video stream. So we wanna isolate those NDI cameras away from all other traffic in order to make sure they don't have any interference from other devices, killing the bandwidth essentially. Again, great technology. We're partners with NewTek, NDI. All our products are licensed for use, and there's other devices, including universal NDI tools that they actually develop. So if you want to use a software program, you can use that. But we actually make our own software program as well called BG Control, PTZ. And this program is amazing. We worked really hard on it. It's got some great preset capabilities as well as zoom and focus. But more than anything, it's set to do those preset locations. You set all your cameras up. You can have a joystick controller as well and then use it as backup. It's definitely a preference, but you can download it at our tech support website. And so lastly, these devices have what's called, again, the control ports, the RS-232, RS-422, RS-485. Decide which way you want to go. I mentioned all that earlier, that technology, whether you want to go serial cables or you want to go with over the local area network with VISCA IP or ONVIF. Again, that's something you need to determine. I recommend VISCA IP or ONVIF as the easier and more friendly used protocols. The main key is to set your network up. If you can set your network up properly, the rest of it isn't so bad. It's really just the network that needs to be done right. You can't get away from that. Doesn't matter the brand, the model, they're all the same. They need to be interfaced. They need to have a web GUI up so you can actually control the pan, tilt, zoom initially to make sure the camera's working properly. All your like sophisticated video settings, audio settings are within this menu. So, you know, again, like our cameras are tailored for our environment. You got LED lights, you got sun coming in. You need to make sure your video settings are set for that. We'll have a video coming up very shortly showing you exactly how to adjust those settings based on a bunch of different little environments, whether it's sun or LEDs or outdoors. Again, most of these cameras are meant for indoor, but you can get away with outdoors with some good shading and whatnot. So, as I mentioned in the beginning of the video, we would like to show you what all three of these cameras look like in this particular video recording. All right, welcome back here. So as you can see, we've changed scenes. We are currently set up in BZBGEAR's demo room in the front. We set this area up for our dealers in order to show some training, give demonstrations to customers. These cameras are fixed on our wall. So let's check out our props and take a look and let us know what you think. Folks, thanks for joining us here at BZBGEAR. We really appreciate you taking a look at our video. Please let us know if you got any comments or questions regarding how we exactly set this up. We're going to have a video coming soon showing our 4K streaming in 4K, as well as Steve, our lead tech, is going to do a little video showing you how we get these video settings. Always adjust your cameras to match your scene. We took our time to ensure that the quality would look really nice when you're dealing with LEDs like we are up above. There's some definite settings that need to be tailored. So we'll have that video soon. If you got any questions for now though, give us a call. Please hit subscribe, like, always appreciated. Leave a comment, shoot us an email, give us a phone call. Thanks again, folks. Have a good one.